Hello, this is Matthias. Today I want to talk about list generate and how this can be used to solve this Excel BI challenge where we have a list of numbers which we need to divide by 7 and then round it up. Then we take this results, divide it again by 7 and round it up again. And we continue to do this until we get to 1. Now let's explain how this works and why list.generate is exactly the right function to solve this. So here we have the numbers and next to them the expected result. And let's do this step by step. So first step is divide. So divide the numbers in column A by 7, and we get these numbers here. Now we need to round this up. We get this results here. We have nowhere a 1 and can stop, so we have to continue this for all of these rows. And we do exactly the 2 steps here and get this here as results for the second round. Here you can see there is a 1, and that means we can already sum this up. So 7 is 6 plus 1, so that's correct. And we don't have to repeat this process now for this row anymore. But for the rest, we have to repeat it. And let's do this here one more time. These are the results then for the third round. And you can see there's another 1. So here we stop. So 1, 3, 18. These together, the 17 here, 22 here. So the problem is, how often do we have to repeat this? We don't know it when we start, and list generate allows us to define a condition how often we are repeating these steps. So now let's do this in the Power Query editor. I have already changed this list to a table with Control T, so I can in the data tab import it with from table range to the Power Query editor. And then I will add a column, a custom column. And the first thing we do, we are building these first 2 steps. So it was number divided by 7 was the first one. And then we can do this here together. Round up. So number round up. Close the bracket. Let's see the result. That's exactly what we have seen before as well. And now for another round, we could add another custom column and another and so on, and then add this up. Or as we don't know how often we have to repeat this, let's go back to the custom column here and bring in list generate. So let's generate. Generate has 4 parameters: initial, condition, next, and selector. And now let's go for all of them. So first, use this here for the initial value. And so we open the bracket, we close the bracket, equal sign bigger. So let's start this function with this. And let's call the value n number. We have defined it already before. So let's take this like that. Close the square bracket here, comma, and go to the next parameter, the condition. And here we define that on the result, the number is bigger than one, we are going to continue this. So now we have to define the function in the next step. So it's next is each as well. And what we actually can do is take the complete first step, because we do exactly the same steps in each of these rounds. The only difference is here, we are not taking number from the column number, but we're taking the previous defined n. So from the previous step, the value n from the previous step. Now that leaves us only with the selector step. And here we define what we want to have as the output. Take n. And we could leave this out because this is optional, but then we would get record as a result. And we don't want to get a record here. We want to get a list of these numbers. Now, let's close this here. And look how the result is. Now we have a list here as a result. List generate makes sense that we get as a result a list. And that result here, we see here it's a 6. And here it's 18 plus 3. So we are missing the last round, the last one. So we would have to add a 1 to the sum of these, this list here, to get the expected results. Let's go one more down. You can see here 3 rounds plus the 1 which we have to add. Now let's go back to the added custom step and bring in the sum to add up the results. Each step, list sum, bracket, close the bracket, plus 1. And you see here, this is what we have seen before, 7, 22, 86. Now just let's close and load this. And I'll bring it here below for comparison reasons. So as table on the existing worksheet, and we go for A10. So there we are. It's exactly what we wanted. And you've seen how easy list generate can be. And you can use it for much more complex situations, but it's good to have it here, practice with a relatively simple function setup. So hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. Until the next time. Thanks.